Welcome to another Cube Draft here on ChannelFireball.com. I've lost my last bunch in round one. Gotta redeem myself. I'm gonna start with Grim Monolith over Grizzlebrand, Force of Will, and Mold Drifter. Alright. Had I taken Grizzlebrand first, I think I would have taken Recurring Nightmare now, but given that I took Grim Monolith, I might just take Huge Archive. I think Huge Archive is a solid card. There's also Cryptic Command, but that's got a lot of blue. Balance, which I've been not that impressed with. Ancient Gruju, which is good, but I'd rather just take the artifact here, so let's see if I can draft a good big mana deck and hopefully get out of round one. Alright, well, some good options here. I'm going to take either Glenland Archmage or Solemn Simulacrum. I think they're both solid cards in the red-blue big mana type decks. Solemn's colorless and fixes your mana, which is an upside. Glenland Archmage is one of the best pieces of disruption against almost any deck in the format, basically. There's also Brainstorm, which I think is fine, but I wouldn't take this early. You have to have a bunch of fetch lands before it really starts being good. Geddon, which I think is decent, and Sword, which I think is just okay. Not a whole lot else here. I'm going to take the Solemn. I'll see where I'm going. I'm not sure yet. Ooh, I actually like Sun Titan quite a bit. There's also Pentad Prism, which is a fine card. Tezzeret, which I've been not super impressed with, though. It gets better once you have cards like Grim Monolith that are, first of all, cheap enough to go get with Tezzeret and also provide a lot of mana. So when you untap it, it does good things. Might just take Pentad Prism, though. Mono Brown, here I come. Ooh, rewarded. Ugin is very, very good. There's also Inferno Titan, which is a great finisher. I like duels in general, but blue-white and blue-black are not really what I'm looking for. And Catamaroons is a fine pickup if you already have a Mindslaver, but I don't find it to be so compelling that I take it early. But I'm just going to take Ugin. My goal is to take all colorless cards, and so far that's working, though. Pentad Prism, not the best colorless card exactly. You kind of want colored mana to make it good. Interesting. I think I'm going to take Staff of Domination. This is shaping up to be a very good Metalworker deck. And Staff in a big mana deck is playable by itself. It's also Lightning Bolt, Faithless Looting, and Avalanche Riders as other potentials, or Thought of Adele, but I'm just going to take Staff. We're on the colorless challenge, except for Duretti. Duretti is very good. Also, gets artifacts in your graveyard, filters through your cards, then also sacrifices artifacts to return artifacts. So it doesn't work with Ugin, unfortunately, because Ugin's just colorless, not an artifact, but very good combo with Solemn. Sacking Solemn is a good time. Same with sacking Pentad Prism or Tap Monolith, actually. Alright, I like Duretti more than Mana Leak, I suspect. That's a late Skullclamp. I might just take Skullclamp here. Not because this is shaping up to be a great Skullclamp deck, but because, well, first of all, nice other cards are ones I'd really consider, maybe Maloku. And also, if I take Skullclamp now, you never know. I can get somewhere. Ooh, Monastery Mentor Skullclamp. Also, Mentor's good with all the artifacts, so I'm going to take Mentor over Seething Song. All right, we've got a brew going here. I like it. All right. Well, there's Augur Bolas, which looks terrible in this deck. There's Emeria Angel, which could work with Skullclamp, but I don't think Emeria Angel's that good, and it's a double white card. I think I'm going to take Tangowire, despite my frequent abuse of the card in terms of not liking how good it is. It might be good in this deck. I've got a lot of cheap ramp. I've got a lot of permanents. And it does work with Duretti. It's just another artifact to sacrifice. Wow, that's a late Armageddon. All right, I'll take Armageddon. No respect. Could I be red-white artifacts? I've never drafted that before, but Geddon's certainly better than Thalia. I'll take Glacial Fortress just in case, though. It's not the kind of land I want. Tundra, on the other hand, that's exactly what I'm looking for. Ooh, Secure the Wastes. This actually looks good. Secure the Wastes with Skullclamp. I'll just cut Isamaru so people aren't taking white. But Secure the Wastes is good with Skullclamp, and it's good with fast mana, so alright, we might have some kind of deck I've never drafted before, but yeah, it could be good here. Alright, now there's Boros Signet, which is looking decent in this deck. There's also Consecrated Sphinx, which might still be the pick. I've got only one red card, and Consecrated Sphinx is among the best finishers. There's also Basalt Monolith, which is a fairly decent card. Huh. And Library of Alexandria. So there's four good options here. Those are the only cards I'm really choosing between. I'm not 100% sure what I should be taking here. I'm kind of leaning towards just Boros Signet, though. Yeah, it's Boros Signet. I'm not that impressed with Library. Boros Signet casts the spells I want. All right, well, now I'm going to take Dak Faden. Dak Faden, I think, is just unrealistically good, and I would rather have Dak than Hangerback or Fast Bond. All right, and also Arid Mesa, Batterskull, yeah. Dak Faden is the card I am looking for. Ooh, Goblin Welder. Now that I have Duretti and Dak Faden, I can see Goblin Welder being pretty good. It's also potentially, I could take Opposition, because I have Secure the Wastes and Monastery Mentor. You know, Goblin Welder wheels a lot of the time. I don't know if it's going to wheel. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, actually, there's a decent chance at wheels. Not a huge chance, but opposition looks insane in this deck. So I'm going to take opposition. Seems like I could get something going here. I've got 2 red cards, 1 blue card, 3 white cards. I do have a Glacial Fortress and a Boros Signet and a Pentaprism, so not going too poorly. All right, well, I still don't really like GTA, and I do like Rakdos Signet, so I'm probably just going to take Rakdos Signet. Fixes red at the very least. Wouldn't mind Wheeling Porcelain Legionnaire. Elspeth would be good in this deck, I think, but and Windswept Heath could also be solid, but Rakdos Signet seems like the pick here. Ooh, this pack's got some action. Strip Mine's very good. Lodestone Golem's not bad, but Gilded Lotus. Gilded Lotus is one of my favorite cards in this archetype, just because it turns your Grim Monolith and Hedron Archive mana into mana that can cast anything. Opposition's, well, I guess it can't cast Dak by itself, but Gilded Lotus is exactly what I'm looking for. Much better than Strip Mine or Lodestone Golem or Enlightened Tutor, though. Those are all interesting cards as well. Alright, and then there's this. Oh, I don't want any of these cards. I could take Force Spike. If I'm white, blue, splash, red, Force Spike's not too bad. Let's see. I don't know that I want... I don't want Palancron. I could take Baneslayer, not because as a main deck card, but as a sideboard card, because there are some matchups where it's quite good. I could also take Temple Garden, because if I pick up like a green, blue fetch, Temple Garden all of a sudden makes my mana a little better. All right, I'm just going to take Temple Garden, I think. And followed up with, I could take Edric. I have a Temple Garden now to go with my Monastery Mentor Secure the Wastes plan. Don't know about all that though. Mystical Tutor doesn't look fantastic here. I might just take Jace, Architect of Thought. I do plan on being heavy blue. There's also a Imperial Recruiter to get Monastery Mentor, but, and Solemn? But no, I'll just take Jace. Jace is a fine card. Ooh, I like Phantasmal Images. Oh, it's also, this is definitely a workshop deck. Look at this. I have Lotus, Solemn, Archive. 2 Signets, Grim Monolith. Yeah. Alright, Mishra's Workshop, that is. I would have taken Phantasmal Image otherwise, but fast mana is really just king. I mean, you want fast mana more than almost anything else. Solidify the Green Splash? Or the Black Splash? I guess I'm slightly more likely to want Sorin, I think, in my deck than Lightning Strike or Temple of Plenty, though I'm not super likely to want any of those. Ooh, Hangerback Wheel, or Walker, Wield. It's also a fast bond. It's a powerful card. It shouldn't still be here, but I'm not going to take it. I'm going to take Hangerback. Hangerback's great with Workshop, great with Skullclamp, great with Opposition. Yeah, basically just great. Better than Impulse, I think. Oh, Goblin Holder didn't wheel, though it's not the end of the world. I still think that Opposition's going to be better here, especially now that I picked up the Hangerback. Take Ranger Views. 1 or less. All right, so Ranger Views can currently get Hangerback Walker. All right. Ooh, Porcelain Legionnaire. Might actually play that. I don't think I'm going to play Mutavault, so I'll take Porcelain Legionnaire to... I guess that's not a white card. Wow, Lodestone Wheel too? Alright, I think it's better than Sword of Light and Shadow. I have Workshop. And casting Lodestone Golem. Alright, Incinerate can be a sideboard card. Probably not playing a Johnny Goldmane. I've never drafted Jeskai Opposition Workshop before, but it looks like it's coming together quite nicely. Well, then I bricked pretty hard here, unfortunately. I'm not up to casting Blightsteel. I was hoping for just like a fat piece of fast mana or a Metalworker, Soaring or Mox. Guess I could settle for Gruul Signet. Not really what I am glad to pick up. I don't really want Clifftop Retreat. I'll play it, but I'm not taking it here. There's also Repeal, which looks solid, but Gruul Signet, I mean, Repeal's good with Monastery Mentor, but Gruul Signet is, the Signets are just very good. Yeah, there's Control Magic also. All right, I'll begrudgingly take a Gruul Signet here. I'm looking pretty good on mana, actually. If you look at Legionnaire as a creature, I've got 3 Signets, Prism, Monolith, Archive, Solemn, Gilded Lotus, and then the Workshop over here. So, all right, this is a little more what I'm talking about. Unfortunately, Tinker not looking insane in this deck because I don't have much to tinker for. I mean, I can tinker for Gilded Lotus, which is nice. I could guess I could tinker for Skullclamp, but that seems a little weak. There's also Mox Diamond, which I like, Wasteland, which is okay. I could take Tinker aspirationally and hope to pick up something. I mean, it is good to sacrifice Solemn or Hangerback Walker. I could also take Warren Power Stone, because that's quite the combo with Mishra's Workshop. Definitely not taking Warzone Signet. At this point, I don't think I'd rather take Ulamog. You know, I think I might just take Tinker over Warren Power Stone. I have such a good Tinker deck, except for one big creature, and all I need to do is find that big creature. Now there's Pestermite and Conscripts. But don't think I'm in that direction, though. Pestermite Could be nice. You can Skull Clamp it at the very least. It's decent with opposition. Skull Clamp, Zealous Conscript to take their one toughness creature. I like Wind Orb and Revoker. I'm probably going to wheel one of these two, so I might just take... I could take Zealous Conscripts just because it's more powerful than Pestermite. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to play Pestermite. All right, I'll take Zealous Conscripts here. Okay. Jar is great. Chalice is pretty good. I might just take Chalice here. I passed on Warren Powerstone for Tinker. Even though Tinker Jar is okay, I don't know. This deck has a lot of card draw already. Maybe I'll just take... I mean, there's also a Johnny, but I don't really want to play red-white because splash cards. I guess that's not that bad of a splash. A Johnny is good with Armageddon. I could see taking a Johnny here. Strange as that sounds. Jar or Chalice or a Johnny. And I'm not taking Hero of Bladehold, though. It's kind of a combo with opposition, but it takes a long time to get going because you have to attack first. I've got a Boros Signet, too. All right, I'll take a Johnny. Planeswalkers are good. Mana Drain. Okay, I'll take Mana Drain. Mana Drain is absurd. I might play less red cards now, but Mana Drain is just a messed up card. I mean, I like Sphinx's Rev, too, but... All right. Still looking for that Sundering Titan, or maybe the Blightsteel will wheel. If I'm the one with Tinker, Blightsteel has a decent chance of wheeling, right? There's Oral Zeric, which is decent. I'm not going to take Careful today. I might just take Spell Pierce. Maybe I'll just be white-blue. I just won't play this like a Johnny Vengeant. And maybe I'll side in the Zealous Conscripts. I'll play Duretti. Because if my mana supports Spell Pierce, I think it's the best card here. I don't like Ral Zeric all that much. And Wall of Omens is cute with opposition, but Spell Pierce is a very good disruptive card. Probably cut this Porcelain Legionnaire also. I'll just play Skull Clamp off Mentor, Secure the Waste, and maybe Hangerback. Seems fine to me. And right now I'm not playing the Tinker, though. Obviously I could get... Oh, this is stuff... Wow, this pack. I mean, I'm not taking Fire Ice, but I do like the card. There's Inkwell for Tinker. There's Trinket Mage, which gets Skull Clamp. And then there's Jace, which is just a generally great card. This might be an Inkwell deck, though, because this makes Tinker... Also, I can cast Inkwell, or I can Duretti it back. And even Trinket Mage Skullclamp is nice, but it's still... I don't have the Nut Skullclamp deck or anything. All right, taking Inky. Cutting Staff, because I'm not getting Metalworker at this point. Metamorph is very good. So is Duplicant. So is Sulphur Falls, though. I like how I've seen only the M10 lands, or M10-type lands. Does the deck want Metamorph or Duplicant? Kind of feels like Metamorph. That card's really good. It also combines nicely with like Lodestone Golem. Alright. Metamorph's hard to resist. Alright, I'll take the Clifftop Retreat. I think I'd rather have Clifftop Retreat than Bonfire. Because my mana's gonna be mediocre already. So I need to cut a couple cards here. I'm not sure which ones to cut. Brimaw's Land Tax Anticipate. Don't think I'm going to play Brimaw's, though. Brimaw's is very good with opposition. Actually, and Skullclamp. All right, I'll take Brimaw's. I'm not going to play any of the other two. Revoker did, in fact, wheel. Sort of Manic Vandal, but I'll just take the Revoker. Can Mox Diamond wheel just once? I don't think that's going to happen, but it would be pretty cool if it did. Oh, did not. I'm going to take Hero, though. I don't think I'm playing this either. I'm going to go ahead and say we don't need a Hero. And Soulfire Grandmaster wheel. Interesting. Can I do anything with that? Not really. Well, I guess I'll take it. I'm not playing Dual Caster Mage anyway. Kind of wish I didn't take the Zealous Conscripts now. That one's not getting there. But I guess I didn't foresee getting past Mana Drain. All right, I need to cut some cards here, certainly. Maybe I do cut Brimaw's just because it's such a weak card if I don't draw one of my answers. Poor little Jack of Pup. And it's a double white card. Yeah, double white probably seals the deal. Cut Tanglewire, most likely. Oh, Wind Orb did not wheel. Unfortunate. I still think Skullclamp is worth it here. I can Tinker or Duretti away Hangerback to make a bunch of 1/1s, or I can just play it for one and clamp it if I really need to. Mentor makes a bunch of 1/1s, and Secure the Waste makes a bunch of 1/1s. I could cut Revoker, but that is also good with, let's see, the opposition. The Skull Clamp, though it's also fine with opposition. Right. Ugin's and Hangerbacks. I have a lot of two drops, some threes. I don't cut Hedron Archive because I have Misha's Workshop, which is Nice little combo. Maybe I do cut Revoker here. And could cut Armageddon. I think I want my red cards. Duretti and Dak are both quite good here. Actually, I think I just cut Spell Pierce. It's just another card. I have too many good playables. Let's side in Spell Pierce, and I have Disruption with Mana Drain and like Armageddon already. Opposition is a pretty good disruptive element. All right. Metamorph costs 3. Yeah, let's play 17 land with Workshop. Let's see. I've got 2 red cards, 3 white cards, and a bunch of blue cards, and I have Pentad Prism, red signet, Gilded Lotus, red-white signet, and then Solemn, plus the Mishra's Workshop. I'm going to play Glacial Fortress and Clifftop Retreat. There's no point in playing Temple of Mystery or Temple Garden. Temple of Mystery is just a come to my tapped land, but it doesn't turn on Glacial Fortress, which seems pretty bad. All right. And right now, 9, 3, 2. Probably don't need 9 blue. Can probably get away with, 9, 10. Yeah, could get away with 8 blue. 3, 3. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, maybe 9 white. That's probably good enough. And then definitely 3's got to be enough red because I have 3 red signets. 4, 5, 7. Yep. And, but I think the key is that 8 blue should be enough. I guess I have 3 double blue cards. Maybe I just play 9 blue and 1 less red. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 red plus Solomon Gilded Lotus. Yeah, that should be plenty. All right. Let's rock and roll.